Hello students of class 9. Today I will continue the chapter Resources of India. I will start from conventional and unconventional sources of energy. What are conventional sources of energy? Conventional sources of energy are those resources with which we are familiar. We are familiar means we are used to. We are using that type of energy in our day-to-day life. Example of conventional source of energy is coal, petroleum, etc. And what are non-conventional sources of energy with which we are not familiar? We are not accustomed with that particular type of energy. Example, solar energy, wind energy, geothermal energy with which we are not used to. Now, here we have to read about the differences between conventional and unconventional sources of energy. These conventional sources of energy we are not used to, we are used to. Conventional sources of energy, these resources are easily available, they are not available. Non-conventional sources are not available, easily available, conventional are not available. Then conventional sources of energy are not eco-friendly, they cause environmental pollution, but non-conventional sources of energy are eco-friendly and they does not cause any pollution. And then example, coal, petroleum, this side, solar energy, wind energy, geothermal energy. Now see, in 108 page, a chart is given. In that chart, the firewood, coal, petroleum, natural gas, hydroelectric power and their advantages and disadvantages are given. You just read one reading. This part is not so important, but whatever I have said, that definition, example of conventional and unconventional energy along with the difference you have to read. But this chart part no need to memorize, just read once. Now, can you tell me what is solar energy? Solar energy means the energy that is generated from sun, tidal energy generated from the tide, wind energy from moving wind by the use of the turbine. Geothermal energy means the energy from the heat of the earth's interior. And biogas energy means from the cow dung, that is biogas energy. Now I am moving to the next part, that is the thermal power, thermal source of energy or thermal power. Every day we are using electricity that mainly comes from the thermal power. The power producing by burning coal, petroleum or natural gas is called thermal plant. So, the power produced by burning coal, petroleum or natural gas in thermal plant is known as thermal electricity. They are very important source of energy and they are most widely used source of energy. Go to next page. The favorable factors for thermal power production are fuel supply, water supply, number 3 market serving, and number 4 economical and political stability. Now distribution. Thermal power plants are found where in Talcher of Odisha, Durgapur, Kolaghat, Vandel, in Chandrapura, Bokaro, in Panipat, in Faridabad, etc. These are the important thermal power producing plant. Next we are going to the hydroelectric plant, hydropower. Hydropower means the power that is generated from running water, or moving water. The electric power which is derived from running water or shifting flowing river by the means of dynamo driven by hydro turbine is known as hydroelectric power. Now, next part is very, very important. What are the factors favorable for the generation of hydroelectric power? Please underline and mark important for 5 marks. There are 2 factors, the physical factors and the economic factors. The physical factors include sufficient and regular supply of water. The generation of hydroelectric power needs sufficient supply of water, means from rainwater. Rough topography. Plain region is not suitable for the generation of hydroelectric power. Rugged topography is essential for the generation of hydroelectric power. The region needs mud free running water. The water must be free from mud. If mud is present, it will eat the machine part. It will destroy the machine part. Need suitable site. Site means place. The region must be geologically stable. The region must have geologically stable region. Next one is economic factor. Economic factor includes population and demand. Huge population with high demand is highly essential, and availability of huge amount of capital. The last point is availability of capital. Without capital, nothing can be done. So all these points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, these 6 factors, 4 from physical environment and 2 from economic environment, is very, very, very important for your exam. 5 marks it will come. Okay, then I am completing this part. In next video, I will continue the part. Thank you, class.